Welcome to lecture number 3 on mechanisms. In the previous classes we discussed about the quick return motion mechanisms, right? And we discussed about the drag link as well as the Whitworth quick return mechanism, right? So today we will try to observe the working principle as well as the construction of the crank and slotted lever mechanism, right? So this is the animation of a crank and slotted lever mechanism. If we appreciate, F to J will be the cutting stroke and G to F will be the return stroke. So return stroke should occur quickly compared to the cutting stroke. So if you observe here, right, so we find a slider, right? So this is one of the inversions of a slider crank mechanism, right? So there are, so again, the one that you see in the purple color will be the extension that will be connected to the tool for a simple slider crank mechanism, right? So now we will explore the construction of a crank and slotted lever mechanism. So one thing that you find here, we see that link number 3 is fixed. So it indicates that the crank and slotted lever mechanism is a third inversion of single slider crank mechanism. We have link 2, which is shown as a crank, which rotates in clockwise direction. Link 1 is shown as a slider, which moves up and down in link 4, which is nothing but a slotted lever, right? This entire thing, the point D of the slotted lever is connected to the tool through link number 5, and currently the tool is at position E, right? And one thing that we have to appreciate is the crank or the point A is going to complete 360 degree rotation, which is shown here. The path traced by point A has been shown here, right? So now we will start with position E1, or I want to start with one of the extreme position and go to another extreme position. Let me consider E1 as the starting point and let me consider this as the end point. So to bring E to E1, what are the changes that has to be made? So E has to come to E1 and I want to consider E1 as the starting position. What are the changes we have made? So we have pulled, so D has moved to D1, currently I am in D1, and A has been moved to A1. So A moves to A1, D moves to D1. So then E moves to E1 and I am ready for the forward stroke. So I was inconvenient to start from E. So I have changed my starting position to E1. Now when I move to E1 to E2, right? So that will be called as the forward stroke. E2 to E1 will be called as the return stroke. That is what I am interested in, right? So now let me see what is going to happen. I said that we moved from D to D1 and A to A1. So correspondingly E moved to E1, right? So now currently E1 is my starting point. Now I want to move from E1 to E2 to show the cutting stroke or the forward stroke, right? Now I am at A1, I need to move to A2 by moving the crank in the clockwise direction. Let me say that from A1 I am able to move to A2, one of the extreme position. In that I am going to travel through an angle alpha. I am moving from E1 to E2, I am going to call it as the cutting stroke, and the angle that I generated through for the cutting stroke is shown as angle alpha, right? So again, I need to travel from D1 to D2. When I move from D1 to D2, A1 to A2, then I am able to make the tool move from E1 to E2 by traveling through an angle alpha. So alpha indicates angle of the cutting stroke, right? So now I want to, again, I am at point, now I am at point D2, I am at point A2, and tool is currently at E2. It has completed the cutting stroke. It has to move back to E1, which is its initial position. So moving back from E2 to E1, I am going to call it as the return stroke, right? So for that, A2 should move back to A1, D2 should move back to D1, and E2 should move back to E1. Let me see what happens. So A2, when it moves back to A1, it travels through an angle beta as shown here. So beta becomes the angle of the return stroke, right? So similarly, D2 moves back to D1 and E2 moves back to E1, right? Moving from right to left. So now if you observe the angle alpha and beta, angle alpha is bigger when compared to angle beta. So alpha is greater than beta. Alpha indicates the angle of the cutting stroke, beta indicates angle of the return stroke, right? Since angle of the cutting stroke is more compared to angle of the return stroke will be much quicker when compared to the forward stroke. That's the basic objective of a crank and slotted liver mechanism, right? So now we will observe what is called as time ratio for a quick return mechanism, in general applicable to all quick return mechanisms. The time ratio is defined as time of cutting stroke divided by time of return stroke, or the angle alpha divided by angle beta. Angle beta can also be represented in terms of the angle alpha. So let me say, so the complete rotation takes 360 degrees, right? So if alpha consumes 300, 360 minus 300, that is the remaining 60 degree will be consumed by beta. And one thing that we have to remember is the quick return mechanism does not depend on amount of work being done or the speed of your input motor. It does not depend on that, but it depends on the geometry of the device or the geometry of the mechanism, so that it is a kinematic property of the mechanism itself to generate alpha greater than beta, right? Angle of cutting stroke should be greater than angle of the return stroke, which is called as the quick return property. If alpha is greater than beta, only then we are going to call the corresponding mechanism as a quick return mechanism, right? Again, we can go back and observe the animation of a crank and slotted liver mechanism, F to G, right? So we can see here F to G will be the forward stroke, G to F will be the return stroke, which happens more quickly, right? So also we can observe a few videos here. We will just play that, right? So you can observe here with the one that you find in the red color here, right? When the tool moves from left to right by traveling through the red portion, that is the cutting stroke, which is angle alpha, when it moves through the green zone, right? So it moves from right to left by traveling through angle beta, right? So this green color is indicated as angle beta and red color is indicated angle as alpha, right? Now you observe that red is more compared to green, angle alpha is greater than angle beta. So it should generate a quick return mechanism, right? So similarly, it can be shown something like this, right? So right to left will be the cutting stroke, and left to right will be the cutting stroke, and right to left will be the return stroke. You can observe here, the one thing that you see here, this will be the forward stroke, which consumes more angle, and this will be the return stroke, which is shown, or which will be lesser when compared to the cutting stroke. So that we can also see the application of a crank and slotted liver mechanism in a shaping machine. So in the forward stroke, it removes the material, and in the return, it comes back quickly to the initial position to begin the next stroke or to begin the next cutting stroke, right? So that's the end of lecture 3. We have completed all the quick return motion mechanisms. In the subsequent lectures, we will start with the mechanisms that can generate straight line for us, right? So thank you.